And this is a really good slide too, and it's titled 33206 through 33208. The question is, yes, pacemakers. Cardiologist implants a new pacemaker, doesn't matter how many leads, and he has a general surgeon create the pocket, puncture the vein for the leads, and close the pocket. The cardiologist does all the rest of the work. Would you build the initial insertion of everything code and then the range with, and I don't think she meant to say 52 because that's reduced services, but I think she meant to say 62 because it is saying 62 on something else. Let's go look. It isn't a reduced service, I can tell you that right now. However, it does get a tad bit confusing, and I was able to find some really good information to just spell it out for you that I think will alleviate the confusion if my computer screen will come up. So there's the question, and again, it is 62. It says that they saw this on LinkedIn for the AAPC forum, and there's the two surgeon, the modifier 62, or an assistant surgeon, modifier 80. She says, I've never coded cardiology, not understanding the procedure well enough. It almost sounds like the general surgeon performed most of the procedure. Well, it would sound like that, and she's right. Ignorance, you know, I always say ignorance is a lack of knowledge, so I'm not saying you're ignorant, but you do have a lack of knowledge of this, and knowing the modifiers will help you out. It doesn't matter which one has more or less. My computer is telling me it's trying to connect, so if I get knocked off, Laureen gets to take over. Yeah, I'm glad you got back.
I can still see it.
Good. Okay. So let's just go ahead and skip down. And again, I think she meant this to be a 52 or 62. So I'm going to go ahead and just change that to a 62.
No, I think she's saying 52. She's very confused. So
okay. So we're just going to spell it out. The answer is it's going to be modifier 62, and that is code for co-surgeons. As long as the codes accept the two physicians and not an assistant. So a co-surgeon is when you have two surgeons, and they're usually because, which Tammy gave me this information, when they're doing pacemakers, she said it's usually because the patient's not in really good health. And then she brought up a point I didn't know, but they'll do these with, it's not general anesthesia. They're somewhat awake, so they can talk to them and ask them, you know, are you feeling okay? Do you have, lightheaded, da-da-da-da-da, which amazed me. But, okay, so let's define what the definition is for two surgeons, modifier 62. So you have two separate surgeons, and they are performing two distinctly different aspects of this procedure. All right, so by adding the modifier 62, you have, let's see, for that procedure, as long as both surgeons continue to work together as primary surgeons. So each surgeon should report the co-surgery once using the same procedure code. If additional procedures, including add-on procedures, are performed during the same surgical session, separate the codes may also be reported. The separate codes may also be reported with 62. So here we go. They're going to tell you. Now note this. If a co-surgeon acts as an assistant in the performance of additional procedures, then or other than those reported with a modifier 62, during the same surgical sessions, those services are going to be reported with modifier 80 or 82 as appropriate. So you've got surgeon 1. Let's go down here and look at this other one. 80 is assistant surgeon. So that means you have one primary surgeon and the secondary surgeon is just assisting the first surgeon. Okay, he's not doing a separate procedure. Now, so I just grabbed 33206, so insertion of a new or replacement permanent pacemaker with transvenous electrodes arterial. So here we go. We got our two surgeons, A and B. And let's say our surgeon 1 is going to insert the pacemaker. Surgeon 2 is going to make the pocket that the pacemaker goes in, and they're also going to close up the pocket, and there was something else that he did. Let me see. Okay, so he's going to create the pocket. This surgeon's going to run the leads down through the veins and into the heart and test it and everything, and then this one surgeon's going to close his pocket up. Okay, so both surgeons are going to write an op report for the same code, and they're going to append that 62. This surgeon is going to say nothing about the surgeon over here, or will distinctly say that this, you know, surgeon B did X, Y, and Z, but this op report is for me, and he's going to sign it, and it's separate. I inserted the pacemaker. He's going to write an op report, and it's going to say, I created a pocket for the pacemaker, and I closed up the pocket. That's my job. That's all he's going to report in his dictation. They're not going to say what the other one did, okay? Two separate op reports, distinct and separate parts of the procedure have to be defined for you to do that. Now, let's go in and say,
No, I was just going to add, a good way to remember it is to think of the surgeons not sharing the patient, but sharing the CPT code. Because
correct.
If they were able to report what they did with their own CPT code, if there was one that existed for that service, and where you could have two different codes, like, you know, the brainstem surgery, there's two different codes, then they wouldn't need 62, even though they're working on the patient at the same time. So it's it's all about splitting the CPT code.
Right. So they both did a pacemaker, you know, implantation, but he inserted it, he created the pocket for it. And then here, if the second surgeon continues to assist, so let's say we got Dr. A and we got Dr. B. He's putting the pacemaker in, he's making the pocket. So, you know, this guy isn't going to walk out of the room because he's also going to stitch it up and make sure the pocket is secure and after the leads and everything are in. So he sticks around, but he's not helping him insert the pacemaker. So then all of a sudden, let's say there was a problem, and he comes in, instead of just doing the pocket, this guy says, hey, I need some help. One of the leads got stuck, or blah, 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 we got a rupture, blah, 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 blood's going everywhere. So he says, I need your help. So he assists him in inserting the pacemaker. He is not a co-surgeon anymore, not a Meyer modifier 62 for that. He is now assisting. And it would reflect in his op report that the other surgeon was assisting him and what he assisted with. Okay, so that's completely different because they still have their two separate op reports, but now he's helping him. They're not two separate entities doing two separate things ultimately of one procedure. So that is the crucial point. Now, when you're reading that op report, it's really not going to be that confusing because if you've got two op reports from two different doctors that put in a pacemaker on the same day for the same patient, they have to be co-surgeons. Okay, because if you were an assistant, you're not going to make an op report. It's one op report, and it'll state, you know, Surgeon A was the primary surgeon, Surgeon B assisted, and Surgeon B is not going to write or dictate an op report. So that's how you can tell. If they say they are co-surgeons, then he has to write and dictate an op report and explain what he did was distinctly different. Okay. It doesn't matter who does the most work. It matters on whether they have an op report that can justify each of their the stuff that they did. And you can be an MD or a DO. It doesn't matter. Now, it does get a little different when you have assistant surgeons and you get into some other modifiers where you're using, somebody that's a PA or something, but that's for another slide. So there you go. That's how you tell the difference. You got two reports, two different doctors, one report, an assistant, and it will state they're an assistant surgeon. So you won't have to be confused. Okay.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.